Have you ever felt a jolt of confusion when learning about electricity? Hey guys, in this video we're tackling one of the most perplexing topics in electrical engineering, the battle between conventional current and electron flow. Stay with us until the end, and you'll uncover the hidden truths that could revolutionize your understanding of circuits and how they work. Let's travel back in time to the 18th century with Benjamin Franklin. When Franklin was experimenting with electricity, he noticed that rubbing a glass tube with a cloth caused it to accumulate a mysterious, invisible fluid. He assumed this fluid flowed inside materials and labeled it positive when there was an excess and negative when there was a deficiency. Based on this idea, Franklin proposed that electricity flows from positive to negative, much like water flowing downhill. This theory became the foundation of what we now call conventional current. Fast forward to the early 20th century, and we meet J.J. Thomson, who made a groundbreaking discovery. Thomson discovered that the particles actually moving inside the wire were electrons, and these electrons flowed from the negative to the positive terminal, completely opposite to the direction proposed by Franklin. This groundbreaking discovery unveiled that, contrary to the conventional belief of current flowing from positive to negative, electrons actually travel in the opposite direction, moving from negative to positive. Visual aids and circuit diagrams can help clarify these concepts. Imagine a simple circuit with a battery, a resistor, and an LED. According to conventional current, electricity flows from the positive terminal of the battery, through the resistor, through the LED, and to the negative terminal. However, the electrons are actually moving in the opposite direction, from the negative terminal, through the LED, through the resistor, and to the positive terminal. This contradiction can be confusing, but it's crucial to understand both perspectives. Early electrical diagrams and symbols were based on the conventional current theory. As a result, all circuit representations show current flowing from positive to negative. This standard was set long before the discovery of electron flow and has persisted, making it important to distinguish between the theoretical and actual flow of electrons when studying or designing circuits. I hope this video has explained the difference between conventional current and electron flow. If you enjoyed this video and want to learn more about electrical engineering and electronics, don't forget to like, subscribe, and check out the links in the description for more in-depth videos. Thanks for watching and see you next time.